Good afternoon. All right, let's go ahead and get started here. Welcome to our June forum for the Thurston County Chamber of Commerce. My name is Trenton Fletch. I am the chairman of the chamber and the president of Sunset Air. We have a great forum on deck today celebrating the 2024 graduating class of Leadership Thurston County. Woo! Just as a raise of hands, who has been a graduate of Leadership Thurston County in years other than 2024? Wow. Pretty cool. Before we get started, I would like to please recognize our chamber ambassadors. Thank you for all your help. Registration, greeting, collecting business cards. We appreciate all you do. Please stand up and wave your hand if you're an ambassador. Thank you. I would like to also thank TAGS Awards and Specialties for their ambassador sponsorship. Thank you, TAGS. I would like to now draw your attention to the table tents and on the screen for information about our upcoming events. You are all cordially invited to a historic celebration marking the 150th anniversary of the Thurston County Chamber of Commerce. The party will be held Thursday, July 11th at the Olympia Port Plaza at 4 p.m. Please drop in for live music, snacks, beverages of the adult variety, and fun activities as we come together to celebrate 150 years of connecting communities. Please scan the QR code on the screen to register for your attendance or to purchase a Friends of the Chamber pendant, really exciting, for the event. All right, to introduce today's program and to more than likely give us a history lesson on the chamber, I would like to please bring to the stage David Shafford, CEO of the Chamber.
How's everyone doing? Woo! All right. Yeah, I got reminiscing about the upcoming party on July 11th, so it's going to be good. We've got some great bands lined up, great beverages lined up, and the weather will be in order. And of course, the port has guaranteed a magnificent facility. So I hope you can attend the July 11th. Yes, go port. Well, good afternoon, everyone. I'm David Shafford, President and CEO of the Thurston County Chamber, and it's wonderful to be here, and it's wonderful, and the Chamber's excited about hosting, once again, Leadership Thurston County graduation. Though, a little bit more business, though, before we get rolling here. I want to make sure I say thank you and invite up to the podium Todd Monahan, LTC Board of Regents, past LTC Board Regents Chair, and is the sponsor of today's graduation. So Todd, if you'd like to say a few words.
You notice David snuck that in there. Todd, we just say a few words. But I guarantee you we'll be out of here about 3 o'clock. Well, it's no problem. Hey, Olympic Rentals and Landlord Services, we're proud to sponsor today's event. I've been involved a long time with LTC, and one of our own, Sarah Black, is graduating today. Yeah, all right. But today is not about Olympic Rentals. David also reminded me about that. The focus shouldn't be here, it should be out there. Oh, about me, that's even worse, yeah. It won't be, I guarantee. Matter of fact, he made me so angry, I'm going to insult all of you over the next 4 or 5 minutes. I'm gonna do that in groups, actually. It makes me pleased to do this because this, you know, LTC is a leadership class that doesn't really go lecturing you about how to be a leader. It's about looking at the community and finding the leadership in the community. So we're gonna do that right now. There are three spheres that I'm gonna divide you up into. You have to select one of them. I realize they cross over. Private sector, nonprofit, and public sector. So would all the private sector people that are trying, that work hard, that own or work in a business and they're trying to make a profit, would you all stand up right now? Even if you're eating lunch, just stand up. You gotta stay standing too. I don't know if I would applaud. I don't know if I'd applaud them yet because I haven't insulted them yet. You gotta stay standing while I insult you, all right? Now, at your worst, you're accused of greed and just transactional only focus on money, greedy capitalist, right? Right? They're selfish, they only here for the money, they take from the employees and the community. You know, they don't invest back in the community. But you know what? I don't know too many people that are standing that do that here in this community. Matter of fact, at their best, I think these are our economic drivers. They create and multiply the resources for our community. They benefit everybody in it. And you know what? Creating wealth is okay. Delivering goods and services that we all use, they do it in a personable way. It's non-transactional. They drive tax revenues for the local governments, and they invest in our community through the nonprofits that we're going to insult here in just a little bit. Now, you look at these people, and especially the graduates, look at these people, because they can help you, because we can learn from them. They are going to lead you, because you know what? They can teach us about return on investment, how to identify and measure efficiencies. They can teach us about being entrepreneurial, nimble, creative, flexible, pivoting in times of challenge, and they can dialogue with their customers better than anybody I ever know. It's not customer service. It's about knowing who you're serving and what they need and want in our community. Would you now join me in a round of applause for this group of leaders in our community? You can sit down, too. Okay, nonprofit sector, you're up. These are for all the people who are trying not to make a profit. I realize that sometimes our businesses fit into that. Hey, Trudy. Hey, this is heckling back there. Yeah. You know, 501c3s, c4s, c6s, these are organizations that intentionally go about their charitable and advocacy duties without traditional measures of profit. At your worst, here we go, Trudy, I'm thinking, yeah. Pie in the sky idealists, sometimes letting the certainty of their core beliefs come in the way, and they denigrate other people in our community because we don't agree with them on everything. You know, they're all bad financial program managers. They spend too much on administrative functions, not on the services they're supposed to be returning to the community. And they're codependent with those same people they serve, and they never really make any progress. You know what? I don't know. This is stuff that I've read in the last month. This is stuff that I've read online and in our press. But at your best, here's what they are. They tackle problems that nobody else seems to be able to address. They work with populations in our community that are spurned by others. And in other cases, they provide programming there's no way the for-profit or the government services could ever afford or do. They create and multiply resources through public and private partnerships. They bring us together in their efforts, and whatever that mission is, and they provide connections for our community members who want to make a difference. Where else could we serve on boards and volunteer? So graduates, look at these people around the room right here. They have a lot to offer you, and you have a lot to offer them. Now, they can lead us by doing the following. They have mission-driven work, and they use language that motivates people because of that mission. As for-profit and government service, we could learn from that. They model and teach us about the dedication that comes with that mission, unrelenting belief and focus in their work, and they do more with less. So how about a round of applause for these community builders here? And finally, the public sector. I've been waiting for this. You usually think of government entities and elected officials, but there's a whole bunch. There's public education, special districts, things like the ports. There's healthcare, environmental, quasi-governmental regulations. Oh, my God, the whole room's standing up. All right, Rick, I'm thinking of you here. All right, at their worst, they're accused of so many things. It was like 20 pages, but I got it down to a few items. They're accused of being gatekeepers who don't open gates, causing unnecessary delays, increased inefficiencies, expenses for public and private projects. You know, they represent only those who think like them, you know, the elected officials, and thus end up trading in raw power, and they don't try to bring people together. And, you know, they forget about the monies that came from our back pocket, right, through the taxes, and it's all coming from your neighbor. I mean, look around at you next to you. That's where the money came from. But you know what? I don't know too many people in the room that are like that, that are serving us in those public services in whatever capacity it might be. Because at their best, they set up effective partnerships for our public lives, and they set up parameters. You know, some bureaucracy is good, right? We want to be safe and have a kind of a playing field that we could work with. They leverage the tax monies that we do give them by creating those partnerships to address the big safety, health, and educational issues that no private service or nonprofit could ever come close to. I can't see us out paving roads, right? Yeah. Perhaps most importantly, they be sure that we all have an equal opportunity to create whatever lives we hope to lead, and they show us the rights and responsibilities to create those lives. So, graduates, look at these people around the room. You should already know some of them because they talk to you throughout the year. They can lead us by offering us, how do we navigate the local, regional, state, and federal bureaucracies to get things done? These people in the room probably know how to do that. Or if they don't, they're frustrated too, and they'll help you later on. They how to draft and implement effective policies and document our history, and how to better become fully participating citizens and really true public servants. So would you join me in giving a big round of applause for these public servants? In leadership Thurston County class, you didn't get out of this either. You better stand up. this year's class. Boy, they did get out of it. They didn't seem to be shy earlier in the year. Got all kinds of things to say to you, but I think people coming up after me will probably say most of it. But now this is your challenge, and I'm going to leave you standing here. You're not going to get a round of applause, and you're going to stand here all day, because really the floor is yours now, and it's up to you to do with whatever you're going to do with all the things that you learned about in this last year. So, and it's not just to you, because community members, look at these people all around. How are we going to support them? What will we offer to them? How will we support them? What will we call forth next? Who will we call up? You guys have the Rolodex for the community now, right? You can call any of these people up and they let you in their office. I can't get into half of their places anymore, and probably nobody will talk to me at the end of this anyway, because we've insulted them. But you still have the goodwill of this whole community right here. And if you look around, there's 250 of us or so. You know, there's 300,000 people in our county. There's 250 or so in this room who are leaders. That's a small enough place you can make a difference. So I invite you to do that. Be generous with your spirit. Be brave, bold, and humble. Stop complaining and take some positive action, and bring others along with you. So Olympic Rentals is proud to sponsor this day for you, and with the support of your community, the next step is yours.
Thank you, Todd. Thank you for the wonderful thoughts. Appreciate it. Anyone's egos bruised? Ow. Yeah, okay. So, here we are. So, on behalf of the Chamber Board, Thurston Chamber Foundation Board, and the Board of Regents of Leadership Thurston County, it is a pleasure to welcome all of you here to celebrate the 30th Leadership Thurston County graduating class. As many of you know, if you've attended a Chamber Forum lately, Trenton made note of it, that I've been sharing just a little bit about the, we'll call moments in time of chamber history that talks about the chamber's 150 years of building community. Today, I thought I'd just simply incorporate that into the introduction of our program today. In 1991, Thurston County Chamber leaders asked the question, how is leadership development and progression occurring in our community? And how do emerging leaders attain the information base, the knowledge, the understanding of their community to make informed decisions? Over the following year, the Chamber had conversations with governments, nonprofits, private sector, all of you that were insulted, about how leadership is occurring in our community. Or maybe it wasn't, the development of opportunities for people to lead. Seeing a community need, the Chamber, along with its newly created foundation, launched Leadership Thurston County, providing organizational support, resources then, and over the decades, the Chamber has worked to ensure the success of LTC. The Chamber is appropriately proud of the efforts of Leadership Thurston County as a critical part of community building. Today, as it was when it was created 30 years ago, there is tremendous and outstanding community support for LTC and its leadership development efforts. Congratulations to all those who participated this last many months, discovering more about your community and how, maybe, or where you'd like to engage in leadership opportunities. Thank you to the employers, real big thank you, to the employers for both your financial support of individuals, but also providing the time. It's not an insignificant ask to be taking that time away for continuing education and opportunities. And Thank you to all the community volunteers. Over 200 of them participated in bringing LTC to the current class. And of course, a big thank you to Alicia Blaine, director, for making success seem to happen time and time again, and she makes it appear so effortlessly, but we know it's not. So thank you, Alicia. So it is now my esteemed privilege to introduce our community speaker for, no, Todd was not it. He had words of wisdom. He was our words of wisdom man. But to introduce our community speaker for the 2024 LTC graduation, friend, colleague, and the first director of leadership, Thurston County, Pam Folsom. A little bit more about Pam. Pam is the communication manager for SCJ Alliance, helping the firm tell its story both internally and externally. Special event coordination and community outreach are also in her wheelhouse. Pam is a graduate of Olympia High School and Central Washington University, where she earned her public relations degree. A year out of college, Pam was hired by the Chamber to write and produce its newsletter. She held literally every position at the Chamber at the time over those next 12 years, including Special Events Coordinator, Government Relations Director, Assistant Director, Executive Director, and as I mentioned, the Founding Director of Leadership Thurston County. After leaving the Chamber, Pam founded Folsom Public Relations, and after 12 years there, joined SCJ, one of her clients at that time. Pam has lived in Olympia for nearly 50 years and is blessed with two children, two grandchildren, and of course, I love this, she included for all of our benefit what kind of person she really is, a five-year-old black lab named Cassie. So her volunteer work is extensive over the past decades, and Pam has enjoyed spending free time with her family, reading and doing outdoor activities, including hiking, fishing, and gardening. Would you please give a very gracious and warm welcome to Pam Folsom.
Oh, this is a bit nostalgic, standing here like David just stood here is what I used to do prior to David doing it, and it's so wonderful to see the mix of public, private, and nonprofit. The original concept for Leadership Thurston County, as David mentioned, it was founded in 1991, but all the way back to 1988, the Chamber at a retreat was kind of a little more inward focused and thought, how are we going to have our leadership succession? Who's coming next and who's behind us? And as that conversation progressed throughout the community, it was discovered that that was something that organizations across the community were having that same challenge. And so as it was talked about and different people shared things at the time, Supreme Court Justice James Dolliver, I actually got to talk to Linda Buckner, our founding Leadership Thurston County Chair last night, and she said, Jim said specifically, I'm tired of seeing the same faces everywhere. And so he actually ended up becoming the vice chair of our first Leadership Thurston County Board. And as David said, 1991, the Chamber established a 501c educational foundation. For me, that was well-timed because that was the birth of my first child and I wasn't wanting to work full-time. The Chamber wasn't ready for a full-time director. And I got the privilege of being able to work with the board members and all of the presenters. Linda shared with me that of every single person they reached out to about sitting on the LTC board, our generous community, every single one of them said yes, except for one who had a work conflict. And that board then spent the next couple years researching throughout the country from Seattle and Tacoma to Tennessee. Different programs have shorter 16-week programs, our challenge day format, and decided what was right for our community. During that time period of touching base with those in the community, what do you think we need, what do we want, I got to have the wisdom of all these already established leaders and different nuggets of what was important. One of the things we did is we had listening groups where we had people come in and just, you know, what do you think about this and that? And some of you may remember Nancy Hoff. She was the director of Associated Ministries for many, many years. And I was at a bank at the time, First Community Bank, with her in a area where we were having a group. And newly married, I had my platter, my crystal platter that I had brought from my own house. You know, we're on a shoot, cookies from Safeway, and my platter, and I'm carrying it back to the kitchen, and I almost dropped it. And I was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe this. I almost dropped it. I got this for my wedding. And Nancy just looked at me and she said, well, it's not like it's a baby. And I'll forever remember that as far as being sure that you put your energy and focus towards the things that are truly important. The purpose of leadership Thurston County established then is the same as today: to develop informed, skilled, and committed civic leaders representative of our area's diverse citizens. How to do that? Enhance leadership skills, broaden understanding of the complex issues shaping our community, and building the relationships to collaboratively address issues of the day and in the future. The curriculum, challenge days, key things: environmental, economic development, government, law, and justice. Some of those may have changed over the years to align with our community, but the on-site presentations, the on-site visits, presentations have all remained the same. After the foundation of putting together the policies, the documents, the budgets, get the board together, all the things that come to creating a well-established organization, it was time to introduce Leadership Thurston County to the community, and that was in 1993. And we had this really fun little promotional program where we had the people in the first class, and in the back it said, I agree, we need skilled, committed leadership who understands the complex issues. Do you want to contribute money? Do you want to be a member of the class, or do you want to volunteer your skills? Well, in January 7th, 1993, unfortunately, I want to mention the week prior to that, Justice Dolliver had a significant stroke. So although he had been our strong advocate and eloquently explained the program, he had to step away from the program at that point. But at that meeting at the Quality in Westwater, where I can distinctly remember buying from some discount place a bag of popcorn as high as my waist to be able to put in centerpieces for our reception after work, we had 250 people show up who thought that this was something that the community needed and wanted to know either how they could be involved in it or how they could support it. So those 250 people and more applicants than we were able to take that first year, the board had decided to start with 27. I think this year maybe 38, so we've grown a bit there. But after starting very similar, it started in the fall with opening retreat, closed at the end of the year. That first year, the graduates gathered under a white tent on the Schmidt Mansion grass and were graduated. There were representatives of public sector, private sector, nonprofits, community volunteers, just like today. I would say unlike today, there was a lot less communication between the public and the private sector, and that need for the cross-pollinating was much more needed. And specifically, I remember one of our strong entrepreneurs who definitely didn't have a very kind view of government at pretty much all levels, but particularly with our local and state being right here, shared at the end of the program with me that of the friends that he'd made in the public sector and people that he thought he could now pick up the phone and call and talk to. And that was exactly, that bridge building was what we wanted to have happen. So we graduated, still on a shoestring budget with hot dogs, salad, cake, and beverages on the Schmidt Mansion lawn. And over the years, that volunteer number, David mentioned over 200 this year. We had 250 that first year. So if you kind of extrapolate that over the last 30 years, that's more than 6,000 volunteers that have helped to continue this program and support you all. And then Leadership Thurston County itself has evolved. I know there's a lot of excitement about the Youth Leadership Program. It's such a wonderful next step. If you don't already know, this summer, the Youth Leadership Program in partnership with New Markets Skills Center will have over 350 students that have already registered to have leadership be a part of their curriculum in their summer. And the purpose remains the same. Dedicate to developing informed, skilled, and committed civic leadership. When I was asked to support the program, and I was only 27 years old, I mentioned that I got to be around a lot of people, and that door-opening comment that you made, Todd, the Rolodex, I missed where you're at now, but the Rolodex, there we go. That was exactly how I felt, too, that every person who came to the class would always offer to the class members, you know, feel free, give me a call. And it's that relationship building. Some of the other aspects and types of leadership, and you've probably seen it within your lives and maybe through a boss or someone in a volunteer organization. Joseph Bullier was the director of the chamber at the time. Linda Buckner, who really led the charge, was the first female president of the Thurston County Chamber. And so Linda and Joseph really, really took the charge there. And one of the things I remember about Joseph as a young woman in a boardroom for the chamber taking minutes is that Joseph would get up and get the coffee pot and take it around the table and pour coffee for me too, not asking me to go do it for everybody else. And that concept of servant leadership and everybody having value was another really strong leadership lesson that I got to learn early on. And so those mentors in our lives and all the people that you've got a chance to come across this year, the relationships within your class. Simon Sinek says, the true value of networking doesn't come from how many people you can meet, but rather how many people we can introduce to others. And so graduates, be that bridge, be the bridge builders between people and ideas to make them come to fruition so that we can have creative, collaborative problem solving for our community. You've had 10 months together, and thank you for the time that you have spent personally. Thank you to your employers for the time. Some David and I didn't coordinate here, but some of the time you gave for the employees. I'm sure there were times for every single one of you that you felt uncomfortable and that there were either topics or conversations that were outside your boundary. Thank you for being willing to entertain that and explore that and sit with that and see if maybe there were some things that resonated on that might change a perspective. Lean into your passions and go forth and do good things. So at this time, I would like to get you formally introduced as you graduate. I'd like to invite Kelly Green, SPSCC's Vice President of Advancement, and the Leadership Thurston County Board of Regents Chair to come to the podium and formally introduce you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Pam. And Todd, if I had known this was going to be a roast, my remarks would have been a little different. So, but good afternoon. As Pam said, I'm Kelly Green. I'm the Vice President for Advancement. at SPSCC, and I have had the privilege of being chair of the Board of Regents for Leadership Thurston County this year. So if you caught all of that and you like acronyms, that makes me the VPA of SPSCC and the COB of the LTCBOR. So. Thank you all so much for being here today to celebrate all of these graduates and the Leadership Thurston County Class of 2024. For the last 10 months, these folks have committed many, many hours of their time to learning about the incredible people, nonprofit organizations, businesses, governments, and everybody in this community that make Thurston County an amazing place to live, work, and play. And why did they do this? Because as Pam just shared, 30 years ago, a group of committed community leaders imagined a better future for Thurston County. They had collective hope, and they knew that to get there, they needed to make sure we are continually supporting the development of informed, engaged, and connected leaders who will keep Thurston County growing and thriving. With this graduating class, Leadership Thurston County has now helped 874 graduates live out that vision. Thank you. And you've already heard some of these names, but I'm going to say a few again because none of this would have been possible without some incredibly special people and organizations that have provided the wisdom, resources, and effort to make it happen. First, a million thank yous to Alicia Blaine Warner. Where'd you go? Ah, thank you. Alicia is the program director. This is her eighth year leading the program, and she does a tremendous job not only managing the program, but helping it constantly grow, evolve, and change to be what our community needs. We also wouldn't be here without a lot of great sponsors, including Olympic Rental and Landlord Services, who you heard from a moment ago. Thank you also to David Schaffer and the leader and the Thurston County Chamber Foundation. Sorry, too many chambers in there. Leadership Thurston County is one of six programs that the Chamber Foundation supports, and none of this would be possible without their continuing support. We also have seven sustaining trustees that ensure the continuity of Leadership Thurston County throughout the years. Thank you to all of these sustaining trustees. They are Capital City Press, the Confederated Tribes of the Chehalis Reservation, Lot Clean Water Alliance, the Port of Olympia, St. Martin's University, South Puget Sound Community College, and Twin Star Credit Union. Many thanks also to my fellow members of the Leadership Thurston County Board of Regents. These folks, if you don't know, are hands-on with every aspect of this program. They provide the leadership and the people to bring the curriculum to life for the class. Board of Regents, would you please stand and be recognized? They're also just a lot of fun to hang out with. And then I'd also like to thank the dozens of community leaders who have been involved in this year's Challenge Days as sponsors, presenters, tour hosts, employers, all of the things that allow our graduates to have the time and tuition that they need to get the most out of their experience. If you're an employer of a graduate or someone who helped with one of our Challenge Days this year, would you wave your hand and be recognized? Well, that's a lot of hands. And lastly, Trenton asked at the beginning, but I want everybody to look around once again and ask, if you are a past Leadership Thurston County graduate, would you wave and show everybody how many of us are in this room? Woohoo, class of 2015. But now it's time to shift our focus to this year's class. I invite you to turn your attention to the screens where our graduates are going to tell you in their own words about their experiences over these past 10 months.
Thank you. So I really enjoyed Education Day. I enjoyed the field trip to check out the New Market Skills Center, as well as hearing from Chris Reichdell, but then especially the teacher panel and hearing directly from them on some of the challenges that they've faced since the pandemic and how we can really support our teachers. So that had a really big impact on me.
So the best experience I had at LTC as far as making the greatest impact was clearly Education Day. Being able to see each of the different school districts and how they worked with the same goal, but then the different flavor in which they did it was really impactful, especially when we go back out in the community, kind of hopefully being able to be the catalyst of that change for our moving forward.
I think the biggest impact on me was our government day. I really loved meeting our local government leaders and seeing how they all interact with each other and how much good they do. And I think our local government actually provides a lot of great bipartisan work. So it was really cool to see that and witness that, and just to see how many people that are leading our community are doing a ton of good.
The leadership Thurston County experience that had the greatest impact on me was the panel of law enforcement professionals. Doing this work every day, it's easy to lose sight of the amazing individuals that are doing this work day in and day out on the street. And listening to a panel of law enforcement professionals speak so articulately and eloquently about the passion for the communities for which they serve was very impactful.
I would say the biggest impact was Health and Human Services Day and the poverty simulation. Interestingly, health is what I do, but that simulation really just brought a lot of feelings and just provided a lot of insight of what it must feel like for so many of the people that my teams care for and in our community, just people living in our community, what it's like to deal with everything that poverty brings. And it definitely made an impact on me.
I think they all had a really great impact, but most of all was probably the poverty simulator, and I think a lot of people were impacted by that. It was just so real so quickly, and you had an extremely visceral response to it, and it's amazing how difficult things can be when you're in that situation and how quickly you'll compromise, even in a fake situation, to do what you need to do to keep your family safe.
I think the main one that had a bit of impact on me was the Culture Day. The reason why is because I felt that seeing other cultures within the Thurston County was amazing. Just seeing some similarities from my culture to other people's culture was great.
I think that just being with the other leaders in the cohort was definitely the most impactful. I think especially after the pandemic, it was really important for me to connect with people in my community, and that definitely gave me the greatest opportunity for relationship building and just being with the cohort in general.
Honestly, it was all the people. So I really enjoyed coming in and meeting all the people, both our fellow peers and the community members. It was super impactful just to be able to network. I'm naturally introverted, so being in that setting and interacting and networking, it actually filled my cup a lot. I learned a lot. But my favorite part, I do have to say, were the field trips, because who doesn't love field trips?
I really enjoyed the Lost Peacock Farm presentation and just her whole journey and how the farm got named and how she met her husband and all that stuff. It was interesting to see somebody so passionate and so real yet determined and positive. With all the potentially negative things that went on, she still seemed positive about it.
One of them is really making sure that everybody on your team has that shared mission, that everybody is working in lockstep toward that same common goal. That really stuck out. And then the other one was the ability to admit failure. Show your team that it's okay to fail, it's just what you do afterward, and create a learning experience from that. I think that you will create an atmosphere of cohesion and camaraderie, and people won't be afraid to try new ideas. And I think that that really is great for any team.
I think that the biggest running theme throughout the course has been communication. I guess the impact communication has on the community, businesses, everything. Inside of business, outside of business, up and down as far as leaders to subordinates, subordinates to leaders, but communication has been the running theme.
I think the aspect that stuck out the most is probably the interaction between the leadership. I think that the way that Olympia worked Thurston County all together, it seems to be unique, is that there's a lot of care from the leadership, so the compassion leading with the heart and the head is really remarkable. And so I think the aspect that I really admire the most was how folks desire to see our community thrive and work together to make that happen.
I think one of the largest insights I took away was the importance of community. It wasn't just about the community amongst your own team that you lead, but also the external community that you're a part of as a team. It doesn't matter what you do for a living, you impact your internal teams and your external teams and communities. So just connections in general, I'd say.
What stuck out to me is that there is definitely a difference between a leader and a manager. And so it's been really interesting to hear about different ways that people are leading in Thurston County, but definitely everyone's willing to jump in both hands, both feet, and get their organizations where they need to be.
One of the insights that I picked up is you can have leadership by title, but you can also have leadership not by title. Leadership is really people taking courage to do the right thing and not to push your way, but to bring people along with you.
A couple things came to mind. One is having a real passion for the work that you're doing, for the organization that you're a part of. And then also, I think, being a reflective leader. So looking some amount of introspection, thinking about what you're doing that's working, that's not working. How is it landing? How is it having an impact? Is it having the impact that you are intending it to? And then I think being empathetic, having a real sense of empathy for the team that you're working with and the community around you is also really important. And those are just things that I've seen over and over again in the many, many different leaders that we've met.
One aspect that stuck out to me is relationship building. It seems like we heard it every month, but not always being the smartest person in the room, but just being able to build those relationships and bring people together to get whatever task done.
The thing that stuck out most to me is it's about the team. Leadership, you think of just as, you know, the president of the United States or, you know, CEO, but it's really about the team that they surround themselves with. And most of the best leaders that we've heard from through this course, they all commend their team and give props to their team that they're a great leader because of them.
A big part that stuck out to me is being your authentic self and leading with servant leadership. I think it's crucial that as we deal with different individuals, being ourselves and sometimes being that lead for somebody else who might not feel like they can be their authentic selves in leadership can do a lot for our community. And then also leading with empathy is really important.
After 10 months of this program, I've started to volunteer a bit more. I've started to reach out to other organizations that I haven't necessarily participated in the past. And I feel like with this program, it's given not just confidence, but it's also given me like an interest in pursuing things outside of my business and of filmmaking, which is something I've been focusing on for the past 10 years. So I think meeting people, learning about organizations within this community, learning about the things that are going on in this community has kind of been a spark for me. And I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna do with all that knowledge, but I think, you know, after a few months of graduating, I'll kind of have an idea of what other interests I wanna pursue beyond kind of what I'm already doing.
I would say just an awareness of how interconnected this whole region is, and knowing that a theme kind of across is that resources are always needed, whether that be financial or manpower or you name it. And so just trying to get involved where able, and just knowing that decisions that are made really impact the entire community.
To me, actually, something that hit home is that I'd really like to be part of the arts and culture community in the sense of helping produce or give opportunities to upcoming ventures. I find it's important that we enhance our community as much as we can, and to me that just struck a bell.
Since I joined Leadership Thurston County, I've become a board member of the North Thurston School District, and so that gave me an opportunity to listen differently to Education Day, for example, which was one of our challenge days. I've already been a strong proponent of volunteerism, and so it just amplifies that for me, but being more intentional about where I put my energy and how I influence others to do the same. So trying to get more people to volunteer, because honestly, It's going to take all of us, all hands on deck, to make the changes that we need to see.
Going out on the tours and like seeing all the different businesses gave me a new perspective and a new understanding of everything that we really have here in Thurston County. So I think that just working with local businesses, shopping local, you know, just supporting everything that we have here in the community is really at the forefront of my mind now.
I think I have a better understanding of what is out there as far as ways to be involved. Like the Arts and Culture Day, for example, I think just even getting out and attending different events that are happening, listening to music, going to comedy shows, getting out and about is just one small way to stay engaged and give back to the smaller nonprofit organizations that are doing so much behind the scenes.
I was thinking about this, and I think that really it's about the connections to the people that are in the cohort and in the group that really are the powerful piece. And so now there's opportunities to reach out to make a difference, to volunteer time, resources. When it was kind of an abstract group or idea, and now there's names and faces associated with it. And it's really, I think, has lowered the bar into getting engaged with the community.
I plan to use the networking and the connections and continuing to build those relationships and having forward momentum so that one day, hopefully, my children and our future generation will see the opportunity that our region has to have a career, start a career here, and hopefully build a family here.
I think continuing these conversations that we've had, meeting so many people with different, you know, we all have kind of what we came into it with of what we're doing in our communities. All of those conversations lead to becoming a better community. And I think that's the thing that I'm going to take is that we're all in this together. Leadership Thurston County gives us the opportunity to learn that through conversation, understanding, listening, and learning that we can have positive change across so many different organizations, industries, and areas in our lives.
The Leadership Thurston County program helped me understand why I'm so proud of Thurston County. There's so many wonderful things here, great people, great organizations. There aren't a lot of gaps in our arts and even in our social structures, our government services. There's so many things here that I didn't understand very well until I went through the program, and I feel it's been a great privilege to do so. I'd like to see thousands of people get the level of understanding that I got about Thurston County.
The program's been amazing. It's way more than I expected or anticipated. I'd definitely encourage anybody that's interested in learning more about the community or getting connected to be involved in it. A lot of the relationships that I've built and people that I've met through the program has been really impactful for me, and I'm just happy to be a part of it.
I think if you're at all interested in the program, you should absolutely do it. It's been just an amazing opportunity both to broaden my network and get to meet lots of other great folks in the community, but really learn how things work here in Thurston County.
LTC was not what I thought it was going to be. And I think that's very good. It was set up in such a way that we can really have these involved conversations with everybody that's within the program. And I think there's real impact, real support for our community that we can develop when we start hearing all these different opinions, thoughts, ideas, and what we can do to support our community moving forward. And it's those sort of experiences that I wasn't expecting coming into the program, but I think are going to be really lasting impacts throughout my career.
I wish I could share everything because it's been an experience. I know for every single person it's been different. For me, it's been really eye-opening to learn more about myself as a leader, but also as a person in the community because I do live in Thurston County. And so seeing the things that are happening within Thurston County and all around us has just made me even more excited to live in Thurston County.
I think it was an amazing experience, and I was a little apprehensive going into it, but I think that it's something that everyone should do, and I don't think it should matter like where in your organization you fall, whether you're a janitor or a CEO. I think it can benefit everybody in every level in every organization.
always an incredible video. I love hearing those stories from the graduate each year, because each year they're a little bit different. I'm going to stay at this mic for just one more moment, and John, I'm going to tap Hope Theory one more time and just say to this year's class that on behalf of the board, with everything that you saw and heard and learned this year, I truly hope you can imagine a better future for Thurston County. I hope that this program has helped you expand your vision, your connections, and your collective capabilities to lead Thurston County into that future. With that, I'm going to invite up my colleague, Jeff Gadman, to get the real party started.
Yeah, I gotta agree with Kelly. That video every year is so inspiring to me as a Board of Regents member. It seems like you're getting out of the program what we're hoping you're getting out of the program, and that's carrying forth this knowledge about the fabric of our community to help everybody else. So yeah, it just gives me goosebumps. So now my small supporting role here, I'm just going to read names. Kelly and David have got starring roles. So we're going to begin. And I'm going to apologize in advance. These names seem pretty straightforward, but if I do mispronounce something, I assure you it was not intentional. It's because my eyesight's going bad, so. All right, Allison Dellwo. And you can apply, yeah. Woo, call her. Amanda Ybarra Rotelli. Amy Zurfluh. Anthony Cooper. Anthony Ray Choke. Arissa De Lima. Aron Dowell. Ashley Stone. Cari Pearson. Chelsea Yarwood. Corey Lopardi. I'm so sorry. I told you my eyes were going bad. Casey Ryland. Okay, Elizabeth Drake. Frankie Peters. Herschel. Jayma Cortlever. Jared Olson. Jason Hardy. Jeff Johnston. Karen Hall. Katie McMurray. Kelly Von Holtz. Lee Lord. Maya Glacier Lawson. Mark Crocker. Michelle Gibson. Olivia Hickerson. Riley Gibson. Robin Spencer. Sarah Black. Sarah Wattenberg. Scott Tompkins. Chantel Owens. Steve Schmitz. And last but not least, Zachariah Davis Price. Congratulations, class of 2024, and I am going to turn it over to Alicia Blaine Warner for closing remarks. No? Video. Oh, video. I didn't get that memo. See?
And may your passion for your community last all your lives, and may you give much to future generations. And we declare you graduated. Thank you all.
Great leaders make great communities. And Leadership Thurston County is a new local program designed to assist in the development of new community leaders. 27 highly motivated applicants taken from a cross-section of Thurston County's population will be accepted for this comprehensive 9-month program. A community kickoff answering questions about leadership Thurston County will be held Thursday, January 7th at the Quality in Westwater from 5:30 to 7. There is no charge for this informational program, open to prospective applicants, program supporters, and volunteers wishing to help in the development of the future leaders of Thurston County. A community is only as vital as its leaders, and Leadership Thurston County offers intensive education and training for the leaders of tomorrow. Call 357-3362 for more information. Again, the Leadership Thurston County Community Kickoff is Thursday, January 7th at 5:30. Be sure to attend if you have an interest in helping to develop Thurston County's 21st century leaders. 357-3362 for Leadership Thurston County.
The story starts back with the Chamber of Commerce in the 80s and how important it was to have a succession of leadership. And after I finished my term and was a past president, I had a little bit of time to devote to organizing and finding a model that would work for our community. I did that along with Joseph Bollier, who was the executive director at the time.
Well, the vision then was to create leaders who understood our community, who understood the issues of our community, who could interchange with different aspects and people within our community, for them to learn who the decision makers were and have good conversations with those people, as well as building a cadre of peers in which they could network with, as well as networking with the decision makers and policy makers of our county.
I was in the first class, 1994. I joined Leadership Thurston County because I wanted to learn the skills necessary to be the change in the world that I wanted to be. So I looked to Leadership Thurston County to help me to prepare so that I could then join organizations and someday hopefully lead those organizations and make a difference in my community. My expectations were not only met, they were greatly exceeded. I've gone on to serve many organizations, 3 as president. So community-wise, it's been phenomenal as I've used the skills and the talent that they helped develop within me. I am forever grateful to Leadership Thurston County. It helped to develop me as a person in a way that no other organization, job, or even position has done that. And it's really added meaning to my life in everything I do.
I was in class of 2009, grown up in Olympia, and just really thought that I knew Thurston County backwards and forwards. And as I got into the class and learned a little bit more, it unveiled for me that there was so much more going on in Thurston County that I wasn't aware of. So it was an incredibly powerful exposure to both networks and opportunities, but then just some of the sites and places and understanding how our community actually works. I hope that future Leadership Thurston County graduates get involved. It is one thing to go through the program and understand the ecosystem that is Thurston County. And that is valuable in and of itself. And teaching folks how everything works is valuable. Where the community gets the highest degree of its return on investment is when those classmates end up volunteering back on various boards, be it a nonprofit board or any, or run for office. Just continue to be involved.
I am a proud member of the 2024 class of Leadership Thurston County. We all want to change the world and make the world a better place for everyone, in from houselessness to mental health to all the things. And it's going to take the entire community to do so. And you can't do that if you don't know what's happening in your community. So my impetus was to get to know others that are change makers and just kind of get to know what's happening in the community so that I can know how to have an impact. The thing that I know that I can do right now is to talk about it everywhere I go. So I'm always talking about, if you get an opportunity to be a part of this program, you should, especially if you're someone who insists that you want to have an impact on this community. I think this is a great resource. And there's, and honestly, again, I've been here for years and didn't even know that this was a thing. So I'm, yeah, so I try to tout it everywhere I go.
I would recommend, frankly, for anybody that is looking to grow their network or understand all the intricacies of the ecosystem that is Thurston County, I don't think that there's a more powerful tool for that.
The community needed leaders then. This community faces challenges and has opportunities. And that need was great then, it's even greater today. Leadership Thurston County develops the skills necessary and the perspective that one needs to be able to make change in our community for the benefit of everyone.
So what is next? I'll get to that in a minute. 30 years of Leadership Thurston County, what a legacy we have created. I am Alicia Blaine Warner, and it is a genuine pleasure to serve as the Program Director of Leadership Thurston County. Over 30 years ago, as you've heard 17 times today, a group of community leaders came together with a vision to create a community leadership program. We wouldn't be here today without that innovation and commitment to community engagement. Joseph Bullier as the Chamber President CEO, Linda Buckner as the Chair of Leadership Thurston County, and Pam Folsom as our first LTC Director, and all of the founding Board of Regents, thank you. I can't even imagine the undertaking the Chamber and then the Chamber Foundation took on to establish Leadership Thurston County, let alone begin to quantify the community impact of the last 30 years. I can only hope that our LTC founders are proud of the direction and work being done by all those involved with our program today. From the class of 1994 to the class of 2024, our community is better because of the relationships built and maintained from Leadership Thurston County. Speaking of the class of 2024, you are so dedicated. I handed out more perfect attendance certificates this year than any other class. Yes. There is so much drive and passion within you. I truly look forward to seeing what you do with your experience. Your engagement and commitment to the program was evident from day one. And sorry, alumni, your class smashed the optional class social record with 23 class members after Government Day. So way to go. Class of 2024, thank you for showing up. Thank you for doing your homework. Thank you for engaging in tough conversations. And thank you for your commitment to our community. I hope you enjoyed your experience over the last year and that you will use your strengths to better Thurston County and beyond. Todd, thank you graciously for sponsoring graduation today. I will be reviewing future graduation sponsor presentations in the future. to all of the facilitators, presenters, panelists, and site visit hosts, thank you for your engagement and sharing your expertise. We truly couldn't run this program without you. To our sustaining trustees, thank you for your ongoing commitment to community leadership. And to the LTC Board of Regents, I know I continue to have some interesting ideas, and I appreciate the encouragement and support, because without your support, we wouldn't be where we are today. So where are we today? Well, in 12 days, yes, 12, because we're crazy, we will be launching our Youth Leadership Thurston County program in partnership with New Market Skills Center. All 350 plus students registered for summer session at New Market will have a day of community and career immersion coordinated and hosted by Leadership Thurston County. From veterinary assistant to culinary arts to cosmetology and auto service technician, each of the 13 programs over the course of 11 days will have 4 to 5 site visits that fit within their career program. Thank you to Twin Star Credit Union and South Puget Sound Community College for being Youth Program Day sponsors. Thank you to Intercity Transit and TAGS Awards and Specialties for being transportation sponsors. And I think the students are the most excited about lunch. So thank you, Freshie, Kylie Jurgens Wealth Management, and Panwich Jewelers for being lunch sponsors. And thank you to 70 of you, and also not in attendance, for sponsoring students. It was my personal goal to, My personal goal was to also have 100 students sponsored for this new program, and we are 30 students away from that goal, so please feel free to pull out your phone, scan the QR code on the screen or on your table tent, and sponsor a student today, because those buses are a little expensive. I am so excited. If you've seen me in the last few months, you'll know I'm very excited for this youth program to grow and already have plans up my sleeve for future development, but we do need to take it one step at a time, one day at a time. So that's what's next, Youth Leadership Thurston County. Thank you again to the Leadership Thurston County Board of Regents for trusting me to create our second signature program. But before I go, LTC alumni, I hope to see you at our 30 years of Leadership Thurston County Alumni Social at Legends Arcade tonight. Our toast to LTC, sponsored by Pack Mountain, will take place at 5:30 p.m. and your attendance includes hosted bites, beverages, and arcade tokens. Come celebrate 30 years of Leadership Thurston County with me. Thank you for joining us today, and I will pass it back to Trenton to close out the Chamber Forum business.
Actually, Alicia, if you'll stay on the stage, we do have a special presentation from your graduating class.
Hi, all.
And
yes.
Alicia, I don't know if you a little.
Gotta get mine out of my pocket, too. All right, gang. Everybody get yours out. Okay. All right, Alicia, the LTC class of 2024 wants to thank you for all you've done for our class and those classes that you've helped in the past. At our last meeting, multiple groups agreed that your skill at corralling 40 adults into events, activities is no small feat. You take care of us, making sure that we have all the materials we need, know where we are going, and we are well fed. And those are just the things we saw. We know that you're behind the scenes making things happen every month, that you're giving us great experiences and training. And then last week, I personally heard multiple people who said that you changed even so far their table tents when they moved their jobs without us even knowing it. Just right by the, it made a difference. They were very happy for that. So it makes a difference, it's the small things. You are an amazing woman, we all love you, but we also have recognized the fact that you changed the world of not just the future leaders, but all the teens that you're working with, all the adults, and this future program that you're having. So with that, we have a couple of things. Riley has a gift from us that is been specifically chosen just for you. It is a and of course, you have to wear it. Yes, absolutely.
Oh my God. That's a must-do right now.
And all the members of the group have chipped in some funds because we keep hearing about this lovely dance group that you've got, and we're donating money to the ESB. Oh We love you so very much.
I would say that's a gauntlet for the next 2025.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Bring it on.
Thank you.
So if you don't know, I've actually been coaching at North Thurston High School. This is my 14th year. Go Rams! And I very openly shared during Education Day that our kids are hurting, and the things I'm supporting my high school dancers with is very different than when I started coaching, and funds are hard, and this is going to change my program for this year. So you have no idea how much this means to me, so thank you.
If you thought $2,300 was good, wait till you see our raffle prize. First off, we have a forum lunch for next month. The winner is Riley Gibson. Riley Gibson. You can come get it right after this. And the next one and the last one is for four Rainiers tickets. And the winner is... Oh, goodness. I don't see a name on that card. That's funny. Brittany Shannon. All right. If everyone who was in this year's graduating class could come up to the stage for a picture following this, that would be wonderful. Thank you. Have a great day.
Deep in her eyes, I think I see a future. I'll be alive.